Now I have a mocha. Who knew candlelighting could be so dangerous? Owl Post number 5. This podcast is done in ASMR style, autonomous sensory meridian response. I take time to explore the sounds of the things that I am handling so that maybe you might experience a little bit of coziness or relaxation or maybe even stimulation to the point of goosebumps or tingling. I have not recorded any of my knitting yet this month, but it will be very easy to do. Lost my photo. So far this month, all I've worked on is my sweater with stormtroopers, which was previously called the Star Wars sweater. I did make some good progress with it. This is the Sweater with Stormtroopers by Natella Astakova. I found this pattern on Ravelry. Last week, I had cast on the cuff of sleeve 2. As you can see, I got the body finished, and both sleeves finished, and I have joined them together. So, I even got the underarms seamed together. Now, I will be knitting for a little bit in the round, and then I will begin the yoke work, which will have decreases in it, and work up to the collar. I hope that I get this finished this coming week. It would be really nice. My main color of yarn is a base called Whirlpool DK in the colorway Chocolat by Krakenmaid, who is Eden Braun. Eden has since closed her shop, but still has an active podcast on YouTube. She is fantastic. It's called Let's Get Kraken, and you should check it out. The contrast colors I'm using are by Barocco Vintage DK. Well, they're by Barocco, and the base is called Barocco Vintage DK. My project has since become too big to fit in my bag without really stuffing it in there. So, when that project is finished, I will be casting on the porcelain sweater, which I did talk about in my recent owl. This is just the information page. And this information is available online. This page has some beautiful photos of the porcelain sweater by Lena Holm Samso, her design company called Lainit. I was figuring out what size I would make and how much yarn I would need. I am very excited to cast this on, and it is my motivation, well, part of my motivation to finish the sweater with stormtroopers. Show you the yarn if you'd like. This yarn is by Homespun House. It is Molly's Soft Sock Fingering Base in the colorway Pickle Juice. I will be holding it with a beautiful amber mohair for the main part. I have this beautiful mohair called Lemon Wedge by Tofino Nitko. And I have this colorway of Electric Feel, which is a non-superwash merino fingering weight. And I'll be holding these two together for the color work. I think it is going to be fantastic, and I cannot wait to see the contrast in the color work. I am very excited to be starting the yoke on the Stormtrooper sweater because the chart looks really fun. So I have a lot of great knitting coming this week. I did not get very far on my socks. In fact, it only got cast on, but that's okay. I love this sweet bag by Olivia of This Handmade Life on Etsy. I've never been much of a monogamous knitter, so because I really want to give this sweater to my husband, I am delighted to be focused on it, which I realize does not make for a lot of fresh content for my knitting podcast episodes, but that's okay. I thought I would share my most recent knitting book purchase. This is Disney Tim Burton's The Nightmare Before Christmas, the official knitting guide to Halloween Town and Christmas Town, put together by Tanis Gray. Tricky to show you this whole book, I am going to feature one pattern that I will be knitting. The Halloween Town Pullover, designed by Tristan Molina of Dragon Horde Designs. How adorable. I love these stripy sleeves. And I do enjoy knitting a good colorwork yoke. Here's another photo. Now, this sweater takes a main color and four contrast colors, although I may use two colors in the sleeves to stripe them two contrast colors together instead of alternating a contrast color and the main color. Here comes some crinkle. Now, these lovely yarn babies come from Dragon Horde Yarn. This is Tristan's Myth Fingering Base. It's a beautiful 75/25 superwash merino nylon. This colorway is called Giggle Juice. Lunar Chaos. Dark Hibernation. Moonbeam. Fairy Moss. Fangs and Bangs. So, what I'm thinking is, stick to the main color of black. I will use the green as prescribed. This is where it gets tricky. I would like two colors for my swirls and two colors in the arms. I think I may use this as my swirl combination. And either main color pink, the arms, or alternate two contrast colors for the arms to make the sleeves extra bright and stripey. two other books in my knit library that I absolutely adore are Harry Potter Knitting Magic, More Patterns from Hogwarts and Beyond. This first book by Tanis Gray has a wonderful house scarf that I've cast on. I think every Harry Potter fan needs a house scarf. My sister and I cast this scarf on quite a while ago, and how we decided to work on it was we would take it out and work on it when we watched a Harry Potter movie. We hoped to be able to watch those movies together, even if it was online through FaceTime or other social media service. This second book, I haven't had nearly enough time to peruse and plan and dream in. But I can tell you that it has many beautiful projects in it. Since I am a big fan of doing color work, I won't be short on any patterns or projects in the coming years. And while we're on the magical subject of Harry Potter, I got the most delicious snail mail today. This sock set is called Happy Birthday Luna. It is on Molly Klatt's soft sock base, which is a 75-25 superwash merino nylon blend, and it is stunning. I am so excited about the Harry Potter birthday clubs that Molly has going on. She just recently closed the Happy Birthday Ron Weasley Club, and currently in the shop today is the Happy Birthday Professor Remus Lupin Club. I am certain that Harry Potter themed colorways are my kryptonite. I just love seeing people's interpretations of the stories and the movies and how they see the characters, the places, and storylines in the Wizarding World. It's one of my favorite fantasy reads and movies by far. As you can tell by my mug collection, all my beautiful, well, most of my beautiful Harry Potter mugs are by the Muggleborn sisters. soon I will do a vlog style episode and show you a little bit more of my mug collection and of the crafty furniture projects that I've worked on. I know you have already seen my old Slytherin desk, and you have seen my Scriven Shafts Quills writing desk. But I have a small cabinet that was themed after Madame Malkin's Robes for All Occasions. Fine robes for all occasions. And I also have a coffee corner to which I painted a antique tea trolley and a little mug shelf, both black, but I have yet to do the Cricut lettering on it. I use my Cricut to cut out vinyl lettering, and it is my intention to make the coffee bar Madame Puttyfoot's tea shop corner, I think. I decided to pull all my marbles needles out of their packaging. There is no reason why I shouldn't enjoy seeing these beautiful colors. Well, I'm not certain they will remain in this canning jar because that canning jar gets active use in our kitchen circuit. I will probably come across some special vessel to put my needles in. Oh, that's probably the last thing I wanted to mention. This week, I heard Molly Klatt of A Homespun House discussing straight needles by Haya Haya that she is going to bring to her shop, and the tips are interchangeable. I have never heard of such a wonderful idea. You can choose the bobble for the end of the needle, and apparently you can twist on several different sizes onto the tips, which, in knitting, when you're working stitches from the left needle onto the right, it's the right hand side's circumference that gives you your stitch gauge. So you could be knitting off of a smaller needle, but it's this needle that's going to set the size of your stitches. I'm just excited to see how these Haya Haya interchangeable straights work out. I am enamored with all the possibilities that are available with needles. And maybe one time, if you're interested, we'll do a podcast episode that discusses the different types of needles available and the different types of needles in my own personal collection. Thank you for joining me. I hope you have a wonderful week. I hope you get to do some making or baking or whatever it is that is a creative process in your life and refills your cup. I think creative people are just wonderful. And I hope there is something that you've read or seen or heard that has inspired you this week to spend some time doing something good for yourself.